Hello and welcome to our basic roofs videos here, CADclips in our Revit Architecture 2011. And this would also be available in Revit Structure as well. Doesn't matter which version. So all I'm going to do is go through these basic roof configurations one at a time. We're going to start with the basic gable roof. All I have is four walls placed. These walls are all going from level one to level two. This is a plan view of my level two over here, which is where I'm going to draw my roof. If I was to go down over here and just to show you, if I go to home and say show my work plane, okay, this is basically where that roof is going to get drawn at that level up over here on my level two. So it's actually quite easy to do. I can go up to my home tab, over to my roof tool and say roof by footprint. Most of these roofs you see on the right are by footprint. So we say roof by footprint, and there's a great little help fly out there for you. You can see the triangular symbols indicate sloping edges. So I say roof by footprint. Now what I can do is go over here and set an overhang and pick these walls. Okay, as I'm placing the roof, I have the option of different, I can pick the walls or pick line work, or I can actually just draw the stuff. The main thing is you need to be on the right work plane. So the first thing I'm going to do is set my roof overhang to be 2 feet. And then what I'm going to do is there's a trick to this. If I try to hit tab right now on my keyboard, I cannot tab to select all these walls. What I have to do is pick in here. I just clicked. Now that I've set this to be my current window, now watch, I can hover over here, tab, and pick. Now automatically it's adding slope on all these edges. All I have to do is grab these two back ones after the fact, hit escape to stop my command. Oh, you see I'm still picking walls. Escape, escape. Now I have to pick these guys. You have to hit a couple escapes to stop picking the walls. Pick both of these guys and turn the slope off. That's going to create the gable at each end. Now I can pick on these guys and actually set the slope by going into here and going over here to my slope on my properties palette, and you know I can set this to be a 712. I don't have to say 12, I can just pick out and it'll change that. So these two sloping up at 712, gable ends at the end, and now all I have to do is go up to here and say finish roof. Okay, it's important that I was on level 2 when I did that, and there's the roof that I have. Now if I don't like the slope of that, I can pick on this after the fact and go over to here and change the slope of that gable roof to be a 1012, and that changes it of course in all the views. Now from inside of here, I'm just going to go back to my home and turn off that work plane. Okay, and there's my 3D view, and I can go in here now and I can either tab to select all these walls or I can pick them individually, and once I do that, all I have to do is go up to here and say attach top base. Okay, and then I go down and I say I want to attach the top, not the base, to this roof, bink, and there I have my gable, basic gable roof, SD on the keyboard for shaded mode, or we can now go down to our nice realistic view once we add materials. So basic gable roof created with roof by footprint and a 2 foot overhang on the side. Okay, does make a difference whether you use the pick walls or if you just sketch the geometry.